Guys, we need to talk about Miss Jo. If you guys are new here, welcome to my channel. My name is Alondra. I really appreciate you guys being here. If you clicked on this video, that probably means that you're either looking to start your weight loss journey with Jo, or you're looking for something manageable, easy to do to lose weight, which is what was my goal when I first started. So I'm just gonna walk you guys a little bit through where I was, where I am, and maybe insert a little clip, a few clips of like me doing a couple of her workouts. I didn't really record many of her workouts throughout my journey. I kind of just did it. So please subscribe if you have not yet done so, and we are going to get right into the video. So when I first decided, I guess, like that I wanted to start taking this seriously, I really wanted to start losing weight, I used one of these little, I don't know if you guys no, Daiso Japan, I'm sure a lot of you guys do, but that's a store that I bought this little notebook at, and I wrote down my goal. This kind of, I don't even look at this part anymore. It's just kind of like the beginning, I guess, measurements, and I'm never really one to like measure myself or like weigh myself and stuff, and so this was something new. I just wanted to track it for like future progress, and now I'm glad that I actually like kept track of like where I was at, because it's good to look back and it feels good to know how much work I've put in, you know. Okay, so I actually went into the 3D body sculpting thing website where you like input your measurements and then like shows what the body image looks like, and actually the representations were very close to what I was when I first started. I'm gonna show you guys, maybe I'll try to put it here or something, or here, whatever. Anyways, so when I first started, I was 248 pounds, but this was about a year ago, maybe a little bit more, where I wasn't thinking about fitness at all. I was just doing my life. It was harder to get into the mental space of like actually starting to work out. I was still really sad. I was sulking in it, and I just couldn't figure out like the right way to go about it. So during that phase, I wasn't really working out as much. Yeah, so that was my initial weight. I guess the first moment you could say that I decided I really needed to make a difference in my life was when I went to the doctor's and the girl weighed me, and I was like face to face with like the actual scale and the digital scale and everything, and it's like it's a doctor office scale, so I mean I could trust it. So I just remember looking at it and I was like, I mean, the last time I was here I was not this heavy, you know. So it took a toll on me, and I definitely didn't have enough self-love practice in yet. I was still in that mental space where I thought that I was smaller than I really was, and then seeing a number just, I guess, kind of made me feel like, I don't know, not too good about myself. Well, I knew that I needed a difference in my life. I needed to make a difference, whether it was I needed to start working out more or start eating healthier. And I tried to stop eating as much out as I was doing, because at the time I was dating my boyfriend and we hadn't moved in yet, so we were just spending all this time going out and eating, and that was all that our money was going to. It was like the most convenient thing to do. We were going on dates, we were just, you know, the happy way. I kind of stopped going out to eat too much. We started going to the gym pretty often, and this was in like February before the March that the pandemic hit. And once everything shut down in March and I was doing so good, I was being consistent, I had lost a couple pounds, everything shut down and my gym shut down, and it just became really hard for me to continue a relationship with like working out when I didn't have the space at home. Mind you, at this time I was living at home with my parents. We didn't have much space because my whole family was living there, and our backyard, my dad had like a shed for his tools, so we didn't have a lot of space for me to be able to just like work out. And I tried to do the best that I could in my room, but it just was not enough space for myself and like working out in that area. So I kind of fell out. The pandemic took a toll on everybody, and I kind of gained a couple pounds back from what I had already lost. My boyfriend and I moved in June of 2020. So March was when everything shut down. April, May, June. So we moved in June, and I guess I was like settling into the house. There's a couple clips that I can insert of me like trying to work out and like trying to make it work in my apartment out there. But the workouts I was doing, I feel like were too high intensity for my body at that moment, especially coming back from like not working out for a couple months at all and then just jumping right back into it. It was really hard. So not only was it difficult for me to start working out here on my own, but I was trying to figure out how to like get a system here, get used to living on my own, get used to living with a partner. I was dealing with a lot of feelings of guilt for leaving my parents' nest and leaving like my younger sibling. But it just came with a lot of things, you know, moving out, as you know, it can be kind of difficult. I didn't have the time very much to focus on my health, I guess, or I wasn't focused enough as I could have been. I'm gonna close that door. It's a little distracting to me. So anyways, I kind of spent most of the year getting used to our apartment, used to living here, you know, and not over there. And once I started this year, I actually like sat my ass down and told myself, like, girl, you need to get your shit together. I had been 231. So 231, you guys can do the math. And that's when I decided, like, yes, we're gonna do this. Like, I need to get back to feeling like myself, because I have so many things that I want to do, and I just wanted my body to be in a place where I can do these things without it being so difficult. I didn't have a specific goal set in mind. I was just trying to feel good. I was trying to get into a place where I felt good about myself, where I didn't have to cancel plans because I felt self-conscious about the way I looked while I was out, or like getting pictures taken in a group and then me being like the worst looking one, at least in my head. I just didn't want to have to deal with any of that anymore. So that was my goal. My goal was just to feel good internally. And I know I could have felt good internally no matter my size. I was having a hard time loving myself and my body at that period of time. Anyways, I was trying to figure out something that was a little bit more like doable for my body. Again, like I said, a lot of the workouts that I started doing were like super high intensity. They were like things I couldn't really do. I wasn't trying to like hop, like get down and jump up and shit and like get on my knees and like do all these sorts of poses that I was just having a hard time doing. Going to the gym was easier than this, you know? So it made me shy away from home workouts for a while. So the journey really started on TikTok, because on TikTok I started seeing a bunch of videos on my For You page pop up about people talking about the benefits of walking and how walking is like super good for you. It makes you lose like weight super quick. And I saw a lot of especially moms talking about how they would take like their newborns on their strollers and go on walks every day, and that's what made them get rid of the baby weight. So I started trying to figure out how I could go on walks. Mind you, I am a female and I get nervous to take walks out honestly at any time of day, just because I never know what will happen. So what I ended up doing was I searched up like indoor walking workouts. And that's when I met Joe. And it was like the perfect timing, because Joe was like a couple months new like to posting. Well, I guess the video that I saw had been like 2 months old maybe. And I was like interested, because I feel like this was like the first time I had seen a walking workout. That wasn't something that I had ever really seen anywhere. And so I clicked on it. I didn't do it, I just watched. Like, I skipped through the video to see, I'm like, is she really walking the whole time? I was like, is that all she's doing? But I started noticing she was doing like workouts in between the walks, and I started seeing like the comments. Everybody was so supportive and talking about how they've lost this much and this much time, and that didn't really matter to me. What mattered to me was just the fact that it was working, and it was like an indoor walking workout, exactly what I needed, exactly what I was looking for, something convenient for me to be able to do it in my apartment, and something low impact, because again, for my body and my weight at that moment, I felt like I couldn't take too much. It was the best decision I ever did. I became hooked immediately after. I started waking up early enough before work to have time to work out and then get ready for work and then go to work. Take a shot every time I say work. I always strive to do anywhere between 30 to 45 minute workouts because I noticed that that's what I could take, and that's where I felt that I was getting a better workout in, where I would sweat more, so it felt like good. I did any of those videos, the ab walking ones, I did the kickboxing ones. Sometimes I would even like put a couple videos together, like a 20 minute one and like a 15 minute one, just to like make it different if I wanted to like change it up a little bit. And I just found myself making it a habit. So slowly, her workouts just, I guess, started working. The pounds were sliding off. I noticed my clothes were starting to fit a little more loose. I was just feeling better. And I hadn't weighed myself in a minute. And then eventually I stepped on the scale again. And this time I was 205. Here's the thing. I stepped on a digital scale in my friend's house one time and it said like 197, and then my scale says 205, so I don't know which one, but pounds are always, it's always shifting, so I'm not gonna go based off the number. So since finding Joe's workouts and being consistent with them, and this was in May 10th 2021, and it is now September 7th, I just did the measurements today, I have lost about, I want to say, 25 pounds. And since my initial weight loss journey, it has been 43. I've lost 43 pounds since. I definitely never thought I could get here, and honestly I probably couldn't have without Joe. Recently I've started doing Joe's workouts maybe 3 days a week, and then I'm working out with my sister next door. She has her own like at home gym set up, and we'll do cardio here with Joe in my living room 2 days a week, two or three depending on how we're feeling really that day. Point is, I've gotten a much better relationship with weight loss and working out thanks to Joe, and I definitely recommend it 100%. Though if you stick with it, you're going to see results. That's really all there is to it. Walking is super, super beneficial. Do not let other people tell you that it's not. And it is now September 7th. My volleyball season starts like next Wednesday, and I'm so excited. I'm finally in a position where I feel comfortable enough to like actually play and to be in the team. When I first joined, again, I wasn't at the best like place, so I was having a hard time playing. I mean, although I knew what I was doing, it was like definitely harder for me to keep up with the team. I'm super excited for this season to start, and yeah, I have nothing but good things to say about Joe's workouts. I am going to continue doing them. Just now it's going to be a little bit more different, just because now I'm starting to incorporate more weights into my workout. I'm going to continue doing her workouts because I frankly haven't reached exactly where I want to be. I feel like I'm in the process of going back to where I felt good, and then I want to start working on myself in a different way. So I'm just super excited that Joe was able to create like a bridge for me and health, and make it such a smooth transition, and make me feel so good with something so simple, you know, something I felt that I couldn't do at home. She showed me I could. So I'm really, really thankful for all of her videos, and I'm really, really thankful for you for sitting through this whole video and for watching and joining me on this little story of my weight loss. We have reached the end of this video, and although I'm sad for this to go, I'm super excited to start working on maybe hopefully other videos for you guys. Like I said, I'm not the most consistent person ever, and you guys, those of you that are subscribed already know this, but I try to throw in a few videos once in a while, and I can't make any promises, but I definitely want to work on some stuff, so we will see in the future. If not, I'm always really active on my fitness Instagram. The handle is aloesweat. I'm gonna put it somewhere here or in the bio below. But my personal Instagram is alondra.pineda if you want to follow me there. But I'm mostly active on my fitness account. If you are interested on any tips, meals, please DM me there. I'm super active. Remember, it is aloe.sweat. Again, the handle is gonna be somewhere here. Thank you guys again so much for watching and clicking on this video, and good luck to you and your journey. Please let me know how it goes for you guys, and I am rooting for you. Thank you guys so much, and I will see you in the next video. Bye.